Saylor had a Twitter exchange with Elon Musk this past December, where he urged Musk to make really this exact move. MicroStrategy owns about 71,000 bitcoins, now worth about $3 billion. Joining us now to discuss is MicroStrategy CEO Michael Saylor. Michael, great to have you back on. And let's just get right to that news of the day. Did you actually talk with Elon Musk offline and share your playbook from, as you put it, one rocket scientist to another?
You know, there are business rules regarding how public company officers are allowed to communicate to the public. And, you know, so I'm constrained in what I can say, but
that's not,
you know what we said on Twitter, and you know what I've been saying all along, which is it's a great idea.
All right. That's not a no. it's not a yes either. So between this move, or I guess because of this move with Tesla today, I'd imagine you're feeling pretty vindicated in your strategy and really what I think the vote of confidence of Musk buying into Bitcoin kind of implies here. I wonder, though, how you would respond to critics who would say that given the volatility of Bitcoin, we just touched on that, the risks associated as an asset class, that you are not only putting the company at risk, but shareholders' investments at risk. How would you respond?
Well, first of all, they were very measured in this. They have plenty of excess liquidity in U.S. dollars. And so I don't think there's any criticism of what they've done. Companies that are converting their dollars into Bitcoin are taking a non-performing asset and they're turning it into the best performing asset. Bitcoin's been appreciating at something like 230% year after year after year for a decade. And so this is part of the digital transformation. They're taking an analog monetary asset and converting it into a digital asset. And ultimately, over the long term, that's going to be good for the business.
Yeah, I mean, I get that Bitcoin has appreciated pretty dramatically, especially in the last couple of months, but it has been extremely volatile as well. So how do you yourself think about that, and how do you discuss that with other companies that are potentially looking to get involved and convert their cash to Bitcoin?
Well, if you take the long view over the decade, you're going to have either a stable loss of 75% of your shareholder value if you hold the money in cash, or you're going to have a volatile appreciation that may very well be doubling every 6 months. And so I'd rather have a volatile appreciation at 200% a year than a stable depreciation at the rate of 15 to 20% a year.
This was interesting to me. This was in the Tesla filing today. As intangible assets without centralized issuers or governing bodies, digital assets have been and may in the future be subject to security breaches, cyber attacks, or other malicious activities, and it goes on from there. How are you keeping your Bitcoin safe?
Well, I think there are institutional-grade custodians right now that have worked out those issues, and corporations are doing all their purchasing, and normally they're doing their custodying with those institutional-grade custodians. This, the same way that you would trust a custodian for other types of assets that you would hold on the balance sheet.
Currency or commodity? And I ask because as we see officials considering the possibility of more regulation to the asset class, how it's defined is going to have implications.
Bitcoin's not a currency. It's digital gold. It's a store of value. And it's taking the place of gold because people realize that you can move a block of Bitcoin a million times faster, and you can program that Bitcoin on a computer to run a million times an hour. So it's the basis of the 21st century cyber economy. It's not going to replace the dollar. It's not going to replace the Visa or the PayPal or the MasterCard payment rails. It's simply a stable store of value to build a financial framework upon.
Yeah, I certainly get that. And I know you laid this out in that conference last week as well with some of your conversations, the hedge against inflation, depreciation of the dollar, and the fact that Bitcoin has appreciated relative to that fiat and others in recent times, and what that means in terms of spending power and that store of value for companies such as yours. I am curious whether and if you are having conversations with other CEOs at other companies. I mean, RBC today just put out a note saying that Apple could be the next likely contender to buy Bitcoin.
I think, first of all, I was surprised. We had more than 7,000 enterprises in attendance last week, and those discussions have gone viral on YouTube. 250,000 or more views of just those sessions in the past few days. I've spoken to lots and lots of CEOs, and I've spoken to lots of other investors and enterprises, and I think the word is spreading pretty rapidly. With Tesla's move, I think they've de-risked this for a corporate treasury. I think you're going to see more CFOs, more treasurers look very hard at this and make decisions.
Yeah, and certainly I know one of those conversations last week was with Ross Stevens at Stone Ridge about all the institutional money that's getting in as well. So I have a feeling we're going to be talking about this even more in the weeks and months and years to come. Michael Saylor, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.